Hello, and welcome to the HOME-ARP IDIS e-tutorials. This tutorial is designed to show home participating jurisdictions, or PJs, how to create administration and planning activities in IDIS for Home American Rescue Plan funding, also known as HOME-ARP. In this tutorial, we'll cover the following elements of administration activities for HOME-ARP: eligible activities, setup, funding, funding drawdown, funding increase, completion, and finally, resources. Administration activities in IDIS allow PJs to draw down funds for HOME-ARP program management, coordination, monitoring, and evaluation. Information about eligible administration and planning expenses can be found in Section 6A of the HOME-ARP Notice and also in the HOME-ARP Frequently Asked Questions on HUD.gov. These resources will be listed at the end of the video. Links to the resources are posted in the video description below. Once a PJ returns its signed HOME-ARP grant agreement to its field office, 5% of the HOME-ARP grant will be made available to the PJ right away to spend on administration and planning. A PJ may incur expenses before the administration activity is set up, but should keep documentation of the expense in case of an audit. Once a PJ's HOME-ARP allocation plan is accepted by HUD, the full amount of the grant will be made available to the PJ, including an additional 10% for administration and planning, for a total of 15%. Of course, PJs aren't required to spend the entire 15% on administration and planning. If a PJ determines that it does not need to spend 15% of its grant on administration and planning, it can choose to use these funds on HOME-ARP project costs instead. Let's say you're a staff member of a PJ that has executed its HOME-ARP grant agreement and returned it to the field office. You can now set up an administration activity in IDIS. This HOME-ARP administration activity cannot be combined with your home admin activity. IDIS will not allow a single activity to be funded with both home and HOME-ARP funds. In addition, HOME-ARP funds may not be expended for home administration and planning costs, and home administration funds may not be expended for HOME-ARP administration and planning costs. To start, you'll need to add an activity in IDIS and associate it with an action plan project. The HOME-ARP administration activity must be associated with a 2021 action plan project. This could be a 2021 home project, a single 2021 HOME-ARP project the PJ will associate with all its HOME-ARP activities, or a 2021 HOME-ARP project set up specifically for admin costs. More details on these options can be found in the Creating HOME-ARP Projects and Activities in IDIS fact sheet on HUD.gov, which is listed at the end of the video and included in the resource links in the video description below. Also, remember that adding any HOME-ARP-specific projects to the 2021 Annual Action Plan will require a substantial amendment. Associating the HOME-ARP admin activity with an existing 2021 home project is the only option that does not require amending the 2021 Annual Action Plan in IDIS. To finish setting up the administration activity, be sure to select the HOME-ARP checkbox on the Activity Setup screen. You should see HOME-ARP Activity Types, not home, available for selection in the drop-down menu. Again, this activity must be separate from any home administration activities. Select ADCOCB and fill out the information about Section 3 applicability and environmental review. Finally, name the activity and save. You may want to take note of the IDIS activity ID for this new home ARP administration activity. You will need it when you want to draw down the funds later on. Once you've successfully set up the activity, you can fund it. To check on the status of the HOME-ARP grant funds in IDIS after submitting a signed grant agreement to the field office, click on Grant in the blue menu bar and search under Home. The 2021 HOME-ARP grant is designated by a blue ribbon near the grant number. There may be a lag time of a few days while HUD processes the signed HOME-ARP grant agreement before the funds are accessible in IDIS. To fund the activity, click on the Activity Funding button that appears on the main activity screen once the activity has been set up and saved. This will take you to the Activity Funding screen, where the amount available will appear as available for funding. You'll fund the activity using the AD subfund, which is automatically set up in the system. Now, since in this scenario the PJ has not yet submitted its allocation plan, the only portion of the HOME-ARP grant that will be available to the PJ is the 5% that can be used for planning and administration before HUD accepts the PJ's HOME-ARP allocation plan. You can fund the activity for the full amount available. It's not necessary to increase the funded amount for an administration activity little by little with each incurred expense. Once the administration activity has been funded, the PJ can draw down its HOME-ARP admin funds. Remember, you may only draw down these AD funds once you have incurred eligible administration costs. More information about eligible administration costs is in Section 6A of the HOME-ARP Notice and the HOME-ARP FAQs linked in the video description. Let's say the PJ has incurred $38,000 of eligible costs related to the preparation of the allocation plan. To draw down funds in IDIS, you'll need to create a voucher under the Funding Drawdown tab, Drawdown menu, just like when creating vouchers for home activities. Please note that if you need more help with the vouchers, this process is described in Chapter 19 of the Home IDIS Training Manual for PJs. Click Create Voucher under the Drawdown menu. Once you are on the Create Voucher screen, you can leave the date blank and the voucher will process on the date it is approved. To draw down funds, you will need to enter the IDIS activity ID for the HOME-ARP administration activity or search for it if needed. To search, click Search for Activities, select Home under Program, and the program year, which should be 2021. Click Search. You should see your HOME-ARP planning and administration activity here. Select by checking the box, then click Add Selected Activities. The activity number will appear listed under IDIS Activity ID. Continue and enter the amount you would like to draw. In this example, we'll be drawing down $38,000 because that is how much ineligible administration costs we have incurred. Confirm voucher, then make sure everything looks okay. Once the voucher is generated and approved, any mistakes cannot be corrected. If the voucher information looks correct, click Generate Voucher. If you agree with the certification statements, click I agree, continue to confirm this voucher, then Generate Voucher. Generate Voucher page 5 should let you know the voucher was created successfully. You may want to take note on the voucher number. It will make it easier to approve the drawdown voucher later on. Every drawdown voucher requires approval from a second IDIS user, one who has drawdown approval privileges in IDIS. Remember that the user who creates a draw cannot also approve it, and that a drawdown must be approved within 90 days of its creation date, or it will be canceled by the system. To approve, select Approve Vouchers under Drawdowns. In case there is more than one available voucher, select the voucher you want to approve. On the Maintain and Approve Voucher screen, click Approve on the HOME-ARP AD voucher. If you have multiple vouchers to approve at once, you can specify a submission date and approve all line items, or choose the specific line item to approve. Once the PJ submits its allocation plan and it is accepted by the field office, the remaining 95% of the HOME-ARP grant will be made available. The system will automatically increase the authorized amount of the AD subfund to 15% of the grant amount. If a PJ would like to spend the full 15% of its HOME-ARP grant on administration, it will need to remember to increase the funded amount of its HOME-ARP administration activity. IDIS will automatically adjust the AD subfund amount, but not the administration activity funding amount. HUD recommends the PJ fund its HOME-ARP administration activity for the entire amount it intends to use, as outlined in the PJ's HOME-ARP allocation plan budget. If a PJ determines later that it doesn't need that much of its grant for admin, it can reduce the activity funding amount, which will return the funds to the AD subfund. To reduce funding, return to the Activity Funding page and click Add Edit. Set the current funding to the lowered total amount for the administration activity. This can be any amount, provided that it isn't less than the amount already drawn. Click Save. Then the PJ can reduce the AD subfund, which will automatically release those funds into the EN, or Entitlement, subfund. Once this is completed, the HOME-ARP EN funds can be used for eligible HOME-ARP project costs. Once a PJ has expended all its administration and planning funds or has no additional administration costs, it should complete the AD activity. Click Check Home and complete the activity with the current date. For more information on the HOME-ARP administration activity, please see the HOME-ARP notice, especially Section 6A, which outlines administration and planning eligible costs, and the HOME-ARP fact sheets, creating HOME-ARP projects and activities in IDIS, in accessing your HOME-ARP administrative and planning funds. There are also helpful FAQs on HUD.gov and IDIS information in the Home IDIS Training Manual for PJs. For additional assistance, send your questions to the IDIS Ask a Question Help Desk on HUD Exchange. Questions can also be directed to the Home ARP mailbox, homearp@hud.gov.